Good morning, this January 11th, 2021. Welcome to Classy J TV for your morning inspiration. I'm going to try to get these inspirations out every morning. I know it's been a while and I just want to get back on track what God wants me to do. So I'm going to start with this reading. I'll give you a little commentary. And hope you enjoy your day. I have to get on my work computer soon, so. This is called The Lion Issue. Please say you are my sister, that it may be well with me for your sake, and that I may live because of you. You can find that in Genesis chapter 12, verse 13. Perhaps some are right when they try to justify Abraham in his deceitfulness. They believe he had good reason to lie since he feared for his life. This becomes a dilemma for many of us. Would we lie to save our lives? As Christians, are we bound to always speak the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help us God? If we were in Nazi Germany and the Nazis asked if we were hiding Jews, would we say yes? We've got three upstairs in a secret closet. Do we then become responsible for the death of those three Jews who would have lived had we lied? Fortunately, we do have a precedent in scriptures where the midwives lied to the Pharaoh because they didn't want to kill the male children. And the scripture says that what they did pleased God. Meanwhile, each of us needs to listen to our conscience, know the scriptures, and pray for wisdom in the face of difficult moral dilemmas that come our way. Father, this day I need your wisdom so that I always do what is right in your eyes. The Sermon on the Mount is without question the greatest sermon ever preached by the greatest preacher who ever lived. It was a prophetic fulfillment of the promised Messiah, magnifying God's law and making it honorable. The religious leaders had dishonored it and made it vain, so that it had lost its power to bring the knowledge of sin to those who have heard it. Jesus changed that by showing that the moral law not only requires us to account for our action, but also for the words we have spoken, the intent in our hearts, and the deeds done in darkness. Most of the world thinks the Sermon on the Mount is a heartwarming sermon when it's truly the opposite. It convicts us. It shows us how far we have fallen short of the glory of God. Those who try to be justified by it are trying to leap across the Grand Canyon with their legs tied. It's impossible for imperfect souls to keep a perfect law. But used rightly, the Sermon on the Mount acts as a mirror to show us our true sinful state. And it sends us to the cleansing blood of the cross. Father, I praise you for the wonderful Sermon on the Mount. And the last scripture would be, I say to you that whoever looks at a woman to lust for her has already committed adultery with her in his heart. Matthew 5, chapter 28. You know, I'm glad I read that this morning because you know, sometime in life, you are faced with issues where you know you're put in a position where you have to lie. Like, okay, I'll use an easy description. Say you're applying for a job, and you haven't been working for the past 6 months because of the pandemic, but we know that spaces in between jobs doesn't look good to a potential employer. So they ask us, have we been working for the past 6 months? Some of us will say yes. Some will say no because of the pandemic. But we have to use our moral compass when it comes to things like that or issues where we don't want to lie, but we do because that makes the situation better than where it is. I tell you, I always wondered about that. I know that, you know, it's a sin to lie, and I always say, you know, I'm human and I err. But if I'm ever in that situation and I am forced to not tell the truth, we know that we could still take it to the Lord, no matter what it is. I, you know, when I do not tell the truth, it doesn't feel good. You know, I'm not the kind of person that I just lie all the time and, you know, I'm dishonest with everyone. No, if I do not tell the truth, it does not feel good. And, you know, I prefer to tell the truth because I want to look good in the face of the Lord. I want to represent Him in the correct way. I'm a child of His. And as I said, I'm not perfect and I err, but I do know that God wants us to come to Him when things do happen and when we do not tell the truth. And He understands what the reason why we did that. You aren't trying to harm anyone. And say you were faced with that situation in the Nazi era when they came to your doorstep and asked you, do you have any Jews in your home? Would you say, yes, they're upstairs in the closet? Or would you say no and save their lives? So I'm not saying it's good to lie. It's not. But God understands when we're in certain positions, when we're forced. We want that job. We want that opportunity, and the only way, but the only thing between you and that opportunity is not telling the truth. And that is a hard decision to make, especially if you're a person like I am who does not like to lie. I'm asking you today, if you're ever put in a position where you do not have to, if you do have to tell a lie, just take it to the Father after. He understands. We're not perfect. And there's situations that are going to come up in your life. And I'm talking to those who want to follow after Christ. If you don't, then this doesn't apply to you. But we have the ability to go to God and ask for forgiveness. We're His children. He's going to forgive you. A Christian journey is not perfect people. You're walking towards being or trying to be like Christ. It doesn't mean that you are like Christ. Just because I do something wrong or another Christian does something wrong does not mean that you are not Christ-like. It means that you're human And we know that we can go to God when something like this happens. Take it to the King. Things that people see or think that I've done wrong, don't judge me. The only one who could judge me is God. And you don't know the conversations that I've had with me and my God. But I do. And God does. And you cannot tell me if my God forgives me or not. Like I can't tell you. My relationship with God is a personal thing. And I will never judge someone's relationship with God because I don't want anyone judging mine. With that said, I want you to have a blessed Monday, blessed start to your week. Classy J loves you. If you're new to this channel, please join us. For inspirations, I talk about a lot of things. I'll have a little fun with cartoons. Sometimes we talk about the news. But what's most important here is we're a family. Everyone here believes in God. Because if they didn't, they wouldn't be here. They'd unsubscribe. Thank you for visiting. Thank you for coming for this morning's inspiration. God held my work phone so that I can talk to you this morning. I thank Him for that. You see how good God is? Usually at this time in the morning, my work phone goes off the rails. And He held it the whole time. See, it's the little things. Have a blessed day. And I'll see you soon.